Hey everyone, I'm here to talk about our solar project, which is a passive solar heater. This project was initialized and designed by architect Devesh Rajbhatrai. I'm assisting him, as well as we have our own team who are doing so. Since last 8 years we've been working on this project, and due to various reasons we had to drop it. And since I guess September 6, 2010, we started doing the project again. In this video, I'll be showing you the components of the solar, the workings, the structure of the solar, as well as the readings that we've been taking since September 6 till this date, September 7, 2010. So, why did we do the solar? There were three things in doing the solar. First, we wanted the solar to be as efficient as the commercial solars. Second, for everyone to be able to make their own solars and use their houses or homes. And third, to make it cost efficient or to make it cost less.
So, as you can see, that's the basic solar that we made. There are only three parts of the solar. The first is the container, second the frame, the third the pipes. That's it. We took a frame that was cylindrical, conical shape, and we took a long pipe that's about 53 meters long in diameters, one inch, and we just wind it around the frame. And there's only two parts in the process: one, the inlet to the cold water, and the outlet to the hot water. So in this video, you'll see the solar that we made, which consists of a storage point, an inlet outlet point. The frame is basically a cylindrical and has certain degree to it. We can also say it's kind of conical shaped, but not exact conical, and that's the outlet point where the water gets stored. So this frame was custom designed by us, and you can make any frame like this with any materials you want. And so that's the structure. Now let's get to the workings. In the workings, as I already said, there are two parts. The inlet, that's the inlet to the cold water, and that's the cold region where the cold water circulates and gets heated up gradually, and that's the hot place where the final hot water gets stored, heated up, and then gets stored into the storage point. So that's the basic working, and it all works on solar as you know it. So that's how the solar looks like. So we thought this was the initial phase of the solar, and we thought we can make it much more better by insulating the regions that were exposed with thermocoils and stuff like that, and making it much more hot, as well as to get maximum thermal gain out of it. So we came up with an idea of using the thermocoils and painting it with black Japan and making it able to absorb much more light as well as heat. And so that's what we got at the end. So as you can see now, the inlet is the same, whereas the structure of the solar has been changed. We have now insulations, that's the outlet. We have now insulations covering the solars, and underneath as well as on the top there's plastic, a thick layer of plastic covering the solar, making a vacuum and making it more insulant. So that's the final product that we got, and it worked wondrous for us.
Well, now I'll be going to some stats for the incomplete solar as well as the complete solar. In this, I'll be showing just basic stuff about what happened when we took the readings for what happened when we took the readings for in partly cloudy and stuff like that. So the interesting thing was in the incomplete without the bottom insulation and stuff, the highest reading we got was 106 degrees for 74 degrees temperature, 74 degree Fahrenheit water temperature. We didn't compare it with the commercial solar because we thought that it would not be fair. And but we compared the commercial solar with our complete solar with the insulation and black japan paint and on pipes and top glaze cover with heavy plastic sheet. That was after September 20, and this was between September 9th to September 19th, September 2010. So for the incomplete, the lowest was 84 degrees Fahrenheit, and when the when it was cloudy throughout, these temperatures were taken. The weather forecast was taken for Nepal through this website. For these days, for the complete one, the amazing fact was we did collect data for the first installation, but we didn't compare it with the commercial one because it was still not complete. But for mostly complete. For the mostly complete and with intermittent sunshine, it was 72 degrees Fahrenheit for the water temperature. It was water temperature. Then we got 105 degrees, and for the commercial one we got 107 for the same temperature, and we found out that the difference was only 1.11, and it was quite impressive. Because the amount of temperature that the commercial was giving was commercial solar was giving was as same as that, as almost same as that of ours. The most successful result was when there was good sunshine throughout. Mind it, this was only for 2 hours. The reading that we took was only for 2 hours for our solar, whereas for the commercial one was, I guess, for 4 hours or 5 hours. So you can see the difference here. For 2 to 3 hours, our temperature, our solar gave 116, whereas for 5 to 6 hours, the commercial solar gave 116 degrees centigrade, and the water temperature was 74, which was a mind-blowing stat. Because within 2 to 3 hours, it gave us 16, whereas for the commercial solar to reach 116 degrees Fahrenheit, it took them almost like 4 to 5 hours, and the difference was zero. So if you want these stats and look, if you want to know about the project more, know the project timeline and the basics, the tubes and the turn number of turns, tube inner radius, the pipes, exposed area, water volume that we use, and also all the calculations, you can ask us in our email, which I'll be giving you at last. And we also have some Autocad drawings for those who want to make the project. You can inform me there and then. So I hope to see you on this regular format. Well, I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you give us some feedback and your reviews on it. And if you want to contact us, our email address is evsolarproject@gmail.com. So see you there, and thank you so much.